Guys, it's kind of hard to hold my excitement in right now, but we just got a pretty freaking amazing update to Black Ops 3. This update brought bonuses for season pass owners. This update brought contracts, which we're going to talk about most of the time in this video. And it brought some new gear like new weapons and things of that nature, which we're going to be discussing throughout the entirety of this video. So sit back, relax, enjoy. Don't forget to click the like button for this awesome, awesome information. Let's get right into it. So when you log on to Call of Duty Black Ops 3 today, you're going to see a little crypto key emblem next to your black market. Clicking on that will bring up this image right here saying, as a token of our appreciation, you have the following bonus items waiting in the black market and Dr. Monty's factory. Black market bonus items include one weapon bribe, a supply drop that guarantees a ranged or melee weapon, a supply drop bundle which includes 10 rare supply drops, and finally, 10 vials of liquid divinium for Dr. Monty's factory so you could try to get gobblegum. This is awesome. So just for being a season pass owner, you get these awesome benefits. And that's if you've had it since day one. That's if you bought it just today. That's if you get it in the future. You're going to be given this awesome season pass bonus. So if you think of it this way, you're really getting like 15 or 16 free rare supply drops, because each one of those 10 rare supply drops, you'll be given extra bonus crypto keys every time you open them, which is awesome. Now for the second order of business, and the most important thing I think I'm going to talk about in this video is contracts. Now, if you guys remember, a couple of weeks ago, I uploaded a video talking about we need this in Call of Duty Black Ops 3, and I was referring directly to Black Ops 1 contracts. Well, I'm happy to announce that these things are actually coming back to Call of Duty Black Ops 3, and they're coming back better than ever, so I don't necessarily know if we'll be able to buy into them with crypto keys, but they may just be given to us as challenges that we need to do on the daily. This isn't a bad thing, though, because there's currently one going on right now, and what you need to do is get 75 wins. Now, currently, at the time of making this video, there is no expiration date. I can't promise that's going to stay no expiration date forever, because they probably want to put a new special challenge in there, but this is pretty cool. You got to get 75 wins. Obviously, that's going to take a long time, but in return, you get 10 rare supply drops, once again, and one weapon bribe, once again, so you get another free weapon, whether it's ranged or a melee weapon. It's still cool to see that they're doing this for people that play the game loyally every single day. Now, another thing you're going to notice above the special challenge is the fact that we have a daily challenge as well as a weekly challenge, and both of them say coming soon. Daily challenges will probably be in the realm of get 100 kills with an SMG, get 100 kills with a sniper rifle, get 100 kills with an LMG, and then you'll be rewarded with maybe a supply drop, or maybe you'll get crypto keys. We just don't know yet. Now, on the other side of the coin, we have weekly challenges, which of course are probably going to last the entire week, and these ones are going to be a little bit more difficult, maybe in the realm of get 50 wins in domination, get 50 wins in team deathmatch, you know, game modes that take a little bit longer, so you're going to need a little bit more time to do, or maybe they'll be based on score streaks that we can earn in game. Earn 10 score streak rewards of wraps, earn 10 score streak rewards of motherships, things that aren't easy to do, but you'll have a better reward. Now at the bottom you can see the special challenge total victory, which we talked about already, but it would be cool if this tab would eventually turn into a community challenge tab. So let's just say the community challenge lasts for 1 week, but they're like really difficult challenges. Let's just say, for example's sake, the challenge was get 1 million total wins. Now I know a lot of people might be saying, wow, 1 million total wins, that sounds like way too much, but if there's 500,000 people playing at the same exact time, there's 500,000 wins right there if we all win at once. So as a community, we can work together to get these challenges and get a big reward unlocked for everybody at the end, whether it is a free weapon bribe, a supply drop, or whatever the case may be. If there's a ton of people working together and they do it within that certain time period, that would be cool. So there could be a start time and an end time, but if you're within that group that played, you'll be rewarded in the end, which would be pretty cool. Now finally, to wrap up this video, guys, there was a bunch of new stuff added, new character gear, and the reason I'm bringing up the character gear is because it's actually unique to each character. It's not the same exact piece of gear just repainted. It's a new, unique-looking piece of gear, which is really, really cool, and there's a couple different versions for each different character, and they're unique to each character, which is awesome. Next up, there are two new bullet-based weapons, or two new ranged weapons, the first one being the FFAR, or the FAMAS remake, which which looks really cool. It's got the highest rate of fire within the assault rifle class, but at that, you have a lot of recoil, which kind of sucks. I can't wait to use this weapon. I really hope that I can earn it with the free supply drop that I get while playing for the Total Victory contract. Secondly, there's a new launcher, which is a semi-automatic launcher. It does less damage, but it's free fire and lock on to ships as well. And then finally, there are two new melee weapons, the mace and the axe, which the mace, it just looks really interesting, and I can't wait to see people running around with that in game. There were also two new calling card sets added, the first one being Retro Activision, showing off some of the retro games that Activision has made. I'm sure we'll see Pitfall in there as well. And then the other one is called Deadly Animals, and I just got a couple of them based off of the 10 free supply drops that I earned, which is pretty nice. I like to see these things added. There's also a bunch of new gestures added, which is pretty funny. I got one called Nunchokes, which if you guys remember the video on the internet of the dude with the nunchucks and he does a backflip and he tries to play it off like nothing happens. He fails the backflip and he's so dazed and he's like whipping the thing around and falls over. That's funny to see that kind of put into the game. I can't wait to do that in the winner's circle. But anyway, I am happy about that update. I'm so happy that they actually put contracts in. Now we have more ways to earn weapons and things of that nature. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. Let me know what you guys get from your free weapon drop as well. I'm really interested in knowing. And if you guys want to see some FAMAS gameplay, let me know as well. I'll try to borrow some gameplay from somebody else if I don't get it off of my weapon bribe challenge. But if you guys enjoyed, once again, don't forget to click the like button down below and subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. We're really close to 1 million subscribers, and I appreciate all of the continued support. Until next time, guys, I'm out. Peace.